Other terms for pneumatosis coli include pneumatosis intestinalis and pneumatosis cystoides intestinalis. And as the name implies, the condition is caused by gas in the bowel wall, usually the large bowel and less commonly the small bowel. When it occurs in adults, it occurs in the late middle age, and when it occurs in neonates, it is usually associated with necrotizing enterocolitis. And it is in the loose tissues of the bowel wall where the gas collects as either bubbles or cysts or streaks in the submucosa or subserosa. And when the bubbles of gas form cysts, the condition is termed pneumatosis cystoides intestinalis. Only around 15% of cases of pneumatosis coli are idiopathic. That means that the condition arises with no known underlying cause, but 85% of cases are secondary to an underlying condition. So, causes of pneumatosis coli include endoscopy and polypectomy, infections such as appendicitis, pseudomembranous colitis, and necrotizing enterocolitis. Ischemia is another cause, and causes of this include volvulus ischemic bowel disease and scleroderma, and respiratory conditions including cystic fibrosis, emphysema, and asthma are also associated with pneumatosis coli. Symptoms include diarrhea, constipation, bleeding PR, abdominal pain, passing mucus, and also passing flatus. Grossly, the appearances are those of polypoid lesions covered by normal mucosa, and the lesions are composed of empty spaces in the submucosa and occasionally subserosa that are lined by macrophages and foreign body type giant cells. This piece of bowel shows the typical features of pneumatosis coli. There are polypoid cystic lesions that are covered by normal mucosa. And if you look carefully, you can actually see the gas bubbles under the mucosa that are semi-transparent. This is a low power view of a colonic biopsy that is falling apart really because of the bubbles of gas present in the bowel wall in the submucosa. That is the part of the bowel wall beneath the thin muscle layer called the muscularis mucosae. Here is another example of pneumatosis coli. Again, the overlying mucosa looks pretty normal. We're just dropping through the muscularis mucosae, and here you can see a collection of foreign body type giant cells. And as we move deeper into the submucosa, there are these empty spaces caused by the gas within the bowel wall. And on the left hand side of the empty space in the middle, you can see multinucleate foreign body type giant cells. And here is a cyst in pneumatosis coli lined by macrophages and foreign body type giant cells.